Good morning, all of you. Today I am going to teach a lesson. Today I am going to teach you 10th standard lesson, Historiography, Indian Tradition. We know very well about our history started. There are the three periods in which period? The first one is the ancient, second one is the medieval, and third one is the modern period. So here the historiography in Indian tradition, here is again there are the three periods started historiography in the ancient period. We already studied about or we learn about the Western tradition of historiography in the last lesson. In this lesson we will know about the tradition of tradition of Indian historiography. So today I am going to giving the information about the historiography in Indian tradition. In Indian tradition it means the first one is the ancient tradition. So what is mean by the historiography in the ancient period? In the ancient period in India, memories of the great deeds of ancestors and mythological lore, also memories of social transition, were preserved with the help of oral recitals. So in the ancient period, we are always discussing about the ancient period in India, memories, a lot of memories related with the ancient history of a great deeds of ancestors. It means before our generation, our ancestors, that lot of story that related with the mythology like Ramayan, Mahabharat. So also memories of a social transition, it means the a lot of changes. So in ancient period there were a lot of changes through the we know about our ancestors and the mythological stories, so we are preserved with the help of the oral recital. So it is through the oral recitals we each and everything preserve our ancient memories. Our ancient memories we preserve through this, it means that our ancestor and our mythological lore. So each and everything preserved. So the inscription on the Harappan seals. So in the ancient history is related Harappan civilization and the Mohenjo-daro civilization. Everyone knowing very well about the Harappan seals. So the inscription on the Harappan seals and other artifacts confirm that Indian had mastered the art of writing as early as the 3rd millennium BCE or perhaps before that. However, the Harappan script is not yet successfully deciphered. It means the inscription on the Harappan seals. So Harappan seals, there are written a lot of things because in that ancient period, we are discussing about the ancient period. So the Harappan seal related with the, there mention a lot of inscription. In that inscription that Indian had mastered the art of writing. Through this inscription on the Harappan seal, and that's why Indians really had mastered the art of writing. That we knowing about our ancient history, that the Indians really had the master of the art of writing as early as the third millennium. Third millennium, it means that the 1000 years. It means that the people in Harappan civilization people aware about the writing skill, and that's why they were written anywhere. It means that is called a inscription. So or prefer before that, however, the Harappan script is not yet successful. There were written a lot of things in that Harappan seals. Some are decoded. It means some language we understand about very well, that decoded the language, and some language is not decoded. Matlab some we understand about that language that already decoded, and some we not understood because that it is not possible to that language is decoded. So the earliest known written documents of historical nature found in India are in the form of inscription. They are dated to the 3rd century BCE, that is Emperor Ashoka Maurya's time. We are discussing about again the ancient period. So it's related with the Samrat Ashok. It's mean the Maurya times. His edicts are inscribed on natural rocks through the through this inscription that Samrat Ashok, that already there were a lot of things related with the Samrat Ashok that inscribed in the rock. Bahut sari cheeze rocks pe likhi gayi hai that related with the Samrat Ashok, and stone pillars that Samrat Ashok that made up the pillars, and there were a lot of things mentioned related with the Samrat Ashok. So in Mohenjo-daro seals and or that the rocks related with the Ashoka Samrat Ashok Maurya, or that the stone pillar that each and everything that inscribed. So we are connecting with the our ancient period. We are connecting with the ancient period, and we understood about the historiography. From the 1st century CE, inscription begin to occur on coins in the 1st century. So all inscription 1st century, when that the 1st century started in CE, inscription begin to occur on coins. So each and everything written on coin in a 1st century. So metal images and sculpture, and also on a copper plate. So already that something just like a metal images hai, or the sculpture hai, or also that copper plate, that each and everything written on such a type of the things. They provide important historical information, such a type of that the coins, copper plate, or that different type of the images, that providing the important historical information. So these things we connected with our historiography. We get to know about the deaths of various kings because of these things, just like inscription. All these things happened because of the inscription. So we get know about the deaths. Nahi to, if they were not written all these things or not written inscription, so we totally unaware about the deaths of the kings. We don't know about the which type of the king, which kingdom. We never understood about anything. So we get know about the deaths of various king, dynastic, genealogy. Genealogy, it means that related with the whole family king history. So territorial extent, how that the king that expand their kingdom. So because of inscription, that because all these things that written through the inscription, and we aware about all these things, genealogy, territorial extent, how that extend their empire, administrative system already mentioned. So various empire and kingdoms, and also important political event, social organization, climate, famines, etc. on respective time. So all these things we knowing about that because of the inscription. Agar ye inscription nahi likha hota, to we totally unaware about our ancient period. We totally unaware about Mohenjo-daro seals. We totally unaware about that the Samrat Maurya, Samrat Ashok Maurya. So it's really very important for inscription. So in your textbook, see the Sohagurak copper plate. There is a inscription already. That inscription related with, see, the copper plate was found at Sohagura. The Sohagura is the place that the Gorakhpur. This place is situated in the Gorakhpur, Uttar Pradesh. It is supposed to be from the Mauryan period. So Sohagura, that copper plate related with the Samrat, related with the Samrat Ashok Maurya. It is supposed to be from the Mauryan period. So it's that our historiographians or historian trying to decode that plate's language. So the inscription on it is in Brahmi script. So that language, it that our historians telling about that inscription related with the Brahmi script. So how that the language, I already told you that language is a they knowing about the writing skill. It means they knowing about the language. So that's why they written on that Sohagura plate. So the inscription on it is in Brahmi script. The symbols known as the tree in railing. So there are so many symbols in that on that plate. See everyone, in your textbook already given that the inscription. So there are tree in railing, बहुत सारे trees दिए in a railing and mountains of the beginning of the inscription and also mentioned that the mountains, tree already that inscribed in that Sohagura copper plate. On punch mark points and already that also that mentioned the mark points. Another symbol which looks like a structure of erected on four pillars and there is mention of the tree, mountains and also that mention about the coins and also there are the four pillars. See, look at your textbook and see there are the four pillars is supposed to be an indicative of a granary. So granary it means that the or tree is already mentioned about that the granary. Okay, and granary it means that the related with the lot of grains. So this inscription related with the food grains. So this inscription related with the food grains. How? See, the inscription records to a royal order that the grains stored in the granary should be distributed carefully. So in that this already mentioned in that inscription that language decoded. It is very important because that language it's very difficult and decoded by our historians. So that what about that mention that it is the full of the portion of that the granary and they use of the food crops or the grains they use very carefully. So it is supposed to be a suggestive of precaution taken in the times of famine. It means in a famine it means the drought. Whenever if that something happened, if the any type of the famine or that the drought happened, so we carefully use such a type of the grains through this inscription that giving the information how we use the grain, how we store the grain. So through this inscription and that the historian decoded the language. So in this Sohagura copper plate that mention each and everything. So the ancient Indian literature including the epics, Ramayan, Mahabharata, Purans, Jain and Buddhist texts, historical travelogues by foreign travelers are important sources of history. So in Ramayan, Mahabharata, everyone knowing it is the it's a Puran. Ye sab Puran hai. It's a epic that related with the mythological story and historical accounts. There are a lot of historical accounts in that mentioned in that the epic book. So Indian authors and also travelogues. Indian authors especially that related that the Indian culture, Indian history and also travelogue by the foreign travelers that mention about that the important source of the history. So not only the Indian authors but the others also giving the priority of the ancient tradition in India. So writing of biographies of kings, how that they came in India and staying in India. So writing of the different type of the biographies. See, writing of the biographies of a king and dynastic histories mark an important step in the Indian historiography. They came and that written the biography. The first, the Indian historiography, Harshcharit, written in the 7th century. So Harshcharit, this is the biography written by the Banabhat, the Harshcharit written by the Banabhat in the 7th century that giving the information about the King's Harsha's biography. So it is very important that we aware about the through this biography, we are aware about the through this biography our ancient history. It portrays a realistic picture of social, economic, political, religious and cultural life during the king's time. So because of this biography we understood about each and everything about that the kingdom. About that kingdom it means that the all these things mentioned in that biography, the how that the social how that the social structure, how was the economy of the king of the Harsha's period, how was the political rule he was established. So each and everything mentioned by Banabhat in Harshcharit biography. So this biography connected with our history. So already everyone knowing the historiography it means that related the past incident. So this is the ancient period and we connected with our ancient period through the historiography, the ancient tradition. So next one, the I already told you there are the three periods. The first one is the ancient. I already provided the information related with the ancient historiography. Now we see the historiography in the medieval period. In ancient period, we are connecting with that Mohenjo-daro, Samrat Ashok. We were connecting with the all ancient times of our kingdom. Now we historiography. Second one is the historiography in the medieval period. Everyone knowing very well the medieval period. It's related with the Muslim period. It means Mughal came in India in 15th century and situated the rule. So in second part, historiography in the medieval period, the style of writing Rajat Ragini, the history of Kashmir by Kalana in the 12th century CE is quite close to the concept of the modern historiography. See the style of writing. What is the style of writing? When that the Kalana, okay, Kalana that written about the Rajat Ragini, that historiography, he was written a book of Rajat Ragini. Kalana was written a book of Rajat Ragini in 12th century, and this book is just showing that the modern historiography. It's related with the medieval historiography period, but we are connecting with that the modern historiography. So Kalana is just writing like a modern historiography. Kalana himself says that he wrote these texts after critically examining. Kalana already said that he wrote himself about critically examining. Usne khud ne bola hai ki when I written about that the Rajat Ragini. So he wrote himself that each and everything critically examine. It is the important thing of historiography, because critically examine, it is a very necessary. Various sources like a monument, dynastic records and a local tradition. So Rajat Ragini, the history of Kashmir by Kalana in the 12th century CE is quite close to the concept of the modern historiography. I already told you, he wrote, he was telling himself ki he critically examined each and everything and written about that the Rajat Ragini. Then Tarike Firuz Shahi, a book written by Ziauddin Barani state the purpose of a historiography. According to the Ziauddin Barani, what he said, historian must not only read the record of rulers' valor and policies of welfare, but also write about the rulers' failing and incorrect policies. What he said about that? Only don't whenever that historian write about that the history, whenever that the historian write about the history, that each and everything mentioned about that the kingdom or that the king, it's a good point or that the bad point. So Tarik-e-Firozi written by Ziauddin Barani. So each and everything mentioned that good things and bad thing also mentioned that each and every historians. The autobiography of Babur, that Tuzuk-e-Babri, the name of that autobiography, that Tuzuk-e-Babri contains the description of the battle fought by him in that Tuzuk-e-Babri, that mention about the Babur fought the different battles and each and everything mentioned about that the battle, describe about the each and everything mentioned in that the book, the name of that the Tuzuk-e-Babri. Also record a minute observation of various region whenever he that the Babur whenever he was going, that also through this observation that already mentioned in the book of the Tuzukiye Babari. Not only about that region, but each and everything mentioned about that, the flora and fauna. So the different type of the things already mentioned in that, the Tuzukiye Babari. Cities there, he was traveling various type of the city, and that different type of the cities, of the ritual, customs, economy, and I already told you that the flora and fauna, that each and everything mentioned about that in that book. Abul Fazl, that written the book of the Akbarnama, important from the viewpoint of the critical historiography. Abul Fazl, that each and everything that mentioned in that way, critical historiography, it's really that examine each and everything critically. So Abul Fazl's Akbarnama, that written each and everything that critically examine. So Bakar, an important type of the historical document in medieval times. Bakar, it is a it's related with the Maratha kingdoms. Bakar, it's related the Maratha kingdom, and medieval period already that mentioned in the Maratha rule or the Maratha power. So contains eulogies of the heroes, the stories of historic events, battles, lives of great men. In a Bakar, I already told you, in a Bakar it's related with the Maratha Empire, that each and everything mentioned in that book. It Bakar, it means that the book, but the name is given, that is called the related with the Maratha Empire. So the name of that the book is the Bakar, of the heroes, stories and historic event. In that, in Sabhasad Bakar, written by Krishnaji Ananta Sabhasad, is a really very important Bakar. In the 20th century, the Indian archaeology exploration and research started under the British rule. Number of ancient sites excavated under the supervision of Sir Alexander Cunningham, the first Director General of the Archaeological Survey of India. So it is very important person, that excavation under control of that the director Cunningham, that playing a very important role. The Harappan civilization was discovered during the tenure of the Sir John Marshall. So the writing of the Indian history by the British official display a strong influence the colonial policy of the British. So after that, it is a really very important thing in the medieval period, that Bakar is a very important thing, Tuzukiye Babari and Tarike Firushai, these are very important biographies related in the medieval period. I hope you understand about the medieval period. Thank you everyone.